Most of the European countries, the training in radiation protection for practitioners in interventional procedures is already existing. But now it's required to have also to insist more in the continuous education, because the technology is improving, is changing, the post-processing is changing, is improving, the possibility to reduce patient doses or improve the image quality is there, and this should be known also on the impact in patient doses and occupational doses for all the professionals, but especially for interventionists.
The new directive on basic safety standards will change the daily practice fundamentally, because you have to report the dose for each procedure and every patient. You don't only record the dose for a single procedure, but for a whole span of years, where you give the patient a report and a feeling how much dose he has acquired over the years.
New EU directive will clearly change our occupational dose management. First of all, we have to reduce our dose, either for eyes and also general exposure, very significantly. We have to adapt ourselves to new reality. Therefore, I believe it will take some time before we be there. But clearly, it will be safer. We'll have a safer practice than we do today.
Now, the new thing is in the directive that you are obliged to work with a medical physicist who is an expert in the field, from the technical and physics point of view. So these two specialities have to integrate their knowledge to the best of the patient.
The main thing is to reduce patient dose by means of performing better the procedures, by means of using a lot simulation before we actually treat the patient.
We should audit this kind of good rules in practice, because we have the obligation to set diagnostic reference levels, to compare our patient dose values with diagnostic reference levels, and to introduce corrective actions without delay if we have our typical values higher than the diagnostic reference levels. And this is applicable also to interventional radiology.
During this conference, we paid special attention to the special needs for pregnant women and the unborn baby if they work in the field of interventional radiology. This was a very interesting session, I think, and very important. If you control radiation protection like we always should, the baby and the mother is safe, even if she continues to work.
The knowledge alone is not enough. We have to practice it, we have to implement it, and it's up to heads of departments and the management of the hospitals to make sure that we really comply with those.
Simple and easy and straightforward. Always use protection, not only on yourself. Use a lead shield also in every situation. Use protective curtains for protecting your legs and feet, and use goggles to protect your eyes. And if you do so and you step out during taking images and you control fluoroscopy and the settings of your angio suite, you are perfectly fit for radiation protection.